Well, if you were lucky enough to be in the audience of a Ross Noble show, be warned, you don't want to arrive late.
In you come, fellas, sit yourselves down. There they are. Don't worry about the lateness at all. To be honest with you, all I've talked about so far is where you are. Yeah, no, welcome along, my friends. It's good to have you here. Did you know tonight, when the two of you meet up, that you are going to be wearing the same outfit? It almost looks like you've turned up, and in case anything kicks off, you've brought a stunt double with you.
Oh, well, there you go. He is one of the best improvisers in comedy, so strap yourselves in. Anything can happen. Ross Noble is here! Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Woo. Hey! Hey! Hello! Hello! Hello!
Hello!
Hello!
Hello!
Hello,
legend. How are you?
Oh, good Lord. Oh, oh, good for one of them. It's lovely to be here.
I just wanted to smell your hair.
That's the last thing you want to do. We don't want you sitting there for the rest of the show. Thanks for sitting me in the youngest audience I've ever been involved in.
Yeah.
I mean, when I first came in, because, I mean, the last time I was here, a lot of nanas.
Yes.
It was, no, you know...
They're just still watching?
There was all the older ladies, and I came in here and I thought you'd done... Maybe it's like an item on skin cream.
Yeah.
You've taken all these old ladies, not one of them is under 70.
Yeah.
And you've just
completely... Amazing, my perfect facial, that's what it is. It's out on the show.
And also the fact that, like,
does
they're all just so young. Young people, and I'm feeling a little bit... He'll be off today.
Got the same hairstylist, all of them.
I was, I was in the dressing room beforehand, and I thought I'll have a nice lie down. And then some idiot come in and dropped a bowling ball on me. Unbelievable.
Just to see what a black hole was.
I'm just saying, don't blame me, blame Albert Einstein.
And also, you've done the place up, haven't you?
We have.
You haven't let me down. And I believe you're responsible. There's still discarded bananas everywhere.
Yeah, okay, yes, I'm sorry. Yes. I'm sorry.
Last time I was here, there was a huge pile of bananas. And then now you're dropping them over the back.
I can't believe you saw that. I was trying to make it nice for you.
It's a disgusting habit, isn't it, Ross?
Behind here is like a compost heap. It's unbelievable.
Yes. Some would say out front of here can be like a compost heap at times as well. Hey, welcome back. It's been ages.
Yeah, it's nice to be back.
It's been said that no two Ross Noble shows are the same. Mm. Do you have like a structure when it comes to your comedy, or do you just come out and just kind of freestyle the show?
It's all scripted. Every single word. So I get the audience members, we get their old actors, we rehearse them for days and days. It's the great joy of stand-up, isn't it? You just, you know, depend on who's in, you have a bit of a chat, see what's happening, and then just follow the ideas.
But to be able to improvise that's cool.
Yeah, well, it's my job. it's the minimum requirement. You can't just go,
one job. No, but some comedians, you're like, oh, God, I've heard this joke again. I've heard this joke before. And, you know, and each comedy show you see is just, it's only slightly different. Then they kind of change. Yeah.
Well, last night I was in Sutherland last night, and there was a woman in front row who was... a psychologist.
Oh.
And, you know, sometimes, find out what people do and that. It's like, oh, they work in IT or something like that.
How am I going to rip off that?
Exactly. And this woman was a psychologist. And, the rest of the show, I wasn't sure whether she was here, like, whether she was there to watch the show or whether she was just, like, doing a bit of research or something. like, ticking things up. You know, like, because normally you look at audience members, you say something, and they'll go, and they'll laugh, they'll go, like that. And this woman was kind of going...
That's unnerving.
Speaking of unnerving, do you ever, before a show, is there a moment where you go, holy, what if nothing comes? Like, what if nothing happens? What if everyone's a psychologist?
Don't put that idea in
there. No, I'm not.
Exactly. I didn't have that.
Sorry.
I'm
just going to go back to my bananas.
I'll just sit there just shaking.
But I mean, you're walking a high wire, aren't you?
Yeah. But that's the same as, like this show. Do you... Like, before you do this show, do you just, like, look at the cameras and go, oh, no, I'm in people's living rooms?
Well, but I don't do it very well.
OK, right.
Whereas you are actually funny.
But also, that's probably better than finding yourself in somebody's living room, actually in their living room, and going, oh, I'm in somebody's living room.
I shouldn't be here.
That actually happens to Jono Coleman quite a bit.
Yeah. Well, he wanders into people's living rooms.
Well, after a few special orange juices, of course he does.
I like the idea that Jono literally, he has all them things that he's selling and he just has them in a van and he just, and to practice, you know, because that's the thing.
Like
you
come know, in and dust?
Exactly. The car, the gore duster. Oh my
so
God.
Good.
I'm upset. I got one of them.
So did I.
I bought one of them. Yeah, but I paid for mine.
Oh,
I didn't just nick it out of Jono's van.
You've got to come to our parties. You'll be fine.
I like the idea that he's got a ute that's just all piled up with all his stuff. The gore duster. I bought one of them. I saw it. Oh, that looks like a bit of fun.
Yeah.
And can I just say, this is not a commercial endorsement. And because you can get in and out all the cracks and stuff.
Because it bends.
And you get in and out the cracks.
Did you get the drain cleaner as well?
The crannies. And that's the thing. Because the one thing people say about me is he's got dusty crannies. dusty crannies. So I thought.
That's all I've ever heard about you. I read it on toilet walls.
Exactly.
And everything.
Dusty crannies.
Call this number for dusty crannies.
Yeah.
Not nooks.
Grimy nooks. I suffer from
grimy nooks.
Grimy nooks.
That's it.
Which is also a brilliant country western singer. If you ever get a chance to see him, Grimy Nooks, he's a Garth Brooks tribute act. And so I've got very dusty crannies, and I caught the gorgeous. I thought, oh, you know, I'll have a little go at that. And it was so much fun. I bought one for my mother-in-law, right? My father-in-law's only got into it.
Oh, no.
He's just...
Yeah. Another one.
Wow.
Two. That's what you want, two. You know the thing for hanging it up on the wall? Fit that to a belt.
Yep. Yeah.
You've got two there. Yep. You go anywhere that's dusty, woof, you're off. Look, these young people.
They don't know what they're talking about.
These
They'll
young people
one,
have no concept of dust at all.
Dust.
Yeah. They don't know
somebody
what
somebody dusts around them.
Except they don't know what dust is. Yeah. You know?
Yeah. I know that you don't like rude people.
I thought you were going to punch me in the face there.
Let's test the theory. Sometimes at the supermarket, you've seen it in action and it's made you a bit upset.
Yeah, How did you know?
Because I'm a good researcher.
Good
I've actually been stalking you for 6 months, following you to Woolies.
I was at the checkout and a woman had, she, you know how they have the 9 items or fewer thing?
Yeah.
And she had 2 baskets.
Oh.
Oh, well, that's not... And she was going, well, I'm going to... They're two baskets with 9 items or fewer, like 8 items each. And I went, well, that's not...
Nah.
That's not less than 9 items.
Maybe she's a Gemini, though.
That'll be what it is. Can I see the two...
split personality?
Yeah, and I'll...
Did you check out Shame Her?
Yeah, I did,
Did you?
I did. I said... Because a lot of people haven't got the... You know, they haven't got the confidence to, you know.
But not that's you. Kind to of humiliate that's, a stranger.
That's the word I'm looking for. Yeah. And it's because I'm a Pisces. that's all she had, just fish. I'd like to buy some bread, but I'm only allowed to buy stuff that you go get. Was it Sagittarius? Is he the
archer?
The Manator.
He's a bull. Yeah.
Sagittarius.
So you have to send a Sagittarian to buy the beef. Pisces is only allowed to buy fish.
And what are we and what
it unless it's crab, of course. You go, I want some crab.
And what do we virgins do?
You have to make your own food at home. So this woman, she's at the checkout, 2 baskets, and I went, nah, that's not happening. And everyone in the queue went, what? He's actually saying this to the... And she went, well, I'm that's what I'm doing. And I went, in her face, this is innocent, but I went, you're a checkout cheat. That's what I said. You're a checkout cheat, right? And this woman went, what? And, like, she sort of turned to the queue as if to say, like, oh, my God, he's called me a checkout cheat. And everyone in the queue all went... Yeah, and started nodding, and then they got on board, and then this other woman just went, yeah, you are a checkout cheat.
Oh my God.
It got to the point where the queue was pretty much a checkout cheat.
That's what I was worried about.
She had to pick up her basket, and then she Oh, I forgot to mention, she had the baskets in a trolley as well.
Oh.
So she was a proper...
Oh, yeah, that's...
I mean,
no place for trolleys.
I mean, she could have quite easily just gone, I'm just doing the shopping for an elderly friend.
Yes.
Which is, you know, but she didn't. She was a checkout cheat.
She was shamed.
And she needs to be taught.
And you know what? She's gone home and she's developed a nice eating disorder now, so...
Well, no, I mean, there was other items than food.
Well,
you know, there was toilet roll, so what she's just...
Do they count towards the nine? Or, like, if you've got a nine pack of toilet rolls, is that...
No, it's not each individual roll, but if you, what if you've got, like, two...
Well, grapes, that would be, like... Yeah. That'd be
hundreds of thousands. What about sprinkles?
What if you've got, say...
I'm sorry, but you can't...
what if you've got, say, half a dozen cans of baked beans or whatever? Does that count as one item because they're all the same?
Absolutely not. If they were in a box to, like...
If it's a yo-go and you've got to snap the pack open... Open.
What if the checkout chick? What if the checkout chick just, you know, scans a thing and then goes times six? So it's like as if it's one thing.
Absolutely not. Okay. Absolutely. In fact, I realised that I had too many items in my basket. And I walked up. I was in my local supermarket. And I walked up and I went, oh, this is no good. And I put the thing out and I counted them. I picked up the basket, and I moved to a different checkout. And the woman came from that checkout and she went, because of your honesty, we're going to put you through this one.
So what does that say?
You are the hero we all need.
That's right.
You really are.
This is what's going to keep society
safe. Where do you shop? Exactly. I need to go there to do all my shopping from now on. And tell me when you go.
All right, then. Let's go on a...
That's not weird.
Let's go on a trolley dash together. Or we could just go and shout at people in the street.
I would like that a lot.
It's got to be done, though. People have got to be called out on these things.
This is probably the loosest interview we have ever done.
I realised I was meant to be plugging the facts I'm on tour. And instead, it's just degenerated into...
Ironically,
I've now been talking for so long that those women are all 80 years of age. They're all just wrinkly and their teeth are falling
out. I've never heard such a loose discussion about anal retentiveness.
Indeed.
It's amazing.
Are you touring the country, Ross?
Yes, I am.
Oh. Right now?
Yes, I'll be appearing.
Can we see you?
I'll be appearing in theatres and supermarkets.
it's called Humanoid. Yes. Humanoid. Get it? And you can get tickets by heading to alist.com.au. Don't be late for his show because you can see what happens. Yeah. And don't take any more than 10 items into the 9 items or less aisle. Ross Noble, everyone. Yay!